Everyone, this is Muhammad Waseem and you are watching my YouTube channel. In today's video, we are going to discuss about Refit client, a nugget package, or we can say a library. Refit client is basically a type safe REST library which helps us in communicating with some APIs using HTTPS. So this series will contain multiple videos in which we will discuss multiple and different aspects of Refit client, but in today's video we are covering how we can utilize it and how we can configure it in our dotnet web APIs. So I have already selected a API which is basically COVID-19 tracker. I just googled it and figured it out. So this is the library and we are using this method. So we are going to retrieve the data using our Refit client. So before diving into VL Studio, let's see that what it brings if we call it from Postman. So this is my Postman and I have already pasted it here and I have created a request. So if I send my request and if I see at results, we have some sort of data that is being sent from this API. So now we have to implement it in our dotnet. How is it possible? So I have already created a dotnet web API in dotnet 7, which basically contains a single controller, which I have named COVID controller, and it has one method, which is get summary. And right now it's not implemented. Then I have added an abstraction which is called iCOVID service, simple interface, and then I have added another service named as COVID service, which is basically implementing that interface. And then I have registered it in my program.cs as a scoped service so we can utilize it. So let's move forward that how we can utilize Refit in it. The first step is that we have to install nugget package, which is called Refit client, refit.http client factory. I have already installed it and if you have to install it. So this is the first step. Now we have to design the model that what is basically how response looks like. So I will basically just copy this data and I am coming here and creating another folder. We can say it models, and then I am adding another file which will act as a response DTO or response model, and I am naming it summary response. So then here I am using a cool feature of VL Studio, which basically creates my classes automatically. So that's how we can see my class has been automatically created. What I have to do is just rename it, and that's all I have to do. I usually like making my class as sealed, so let's make them sealed so because no one is going to inherit from these classes. Okay, so this is our response model. Now we have to do another thing, that we have to create an interface which will basically our Refit client interface that will help us in communicating. So I am naming it COVID service Refit API. So it would be a interface. Okay, so this is complaining because I have set configurations that when I miss I in start of interface, then it will complain. Yes. Okay, so let me rename that as well. Okay, so it looks fine now. And now we have to add a method. So basically, normally we use HTTP GET in our REST API, but when we are working with Refit client, we will not add GET. So if we are making a GET get API, making call for get API, then we will use get instead of HTTP get for post, we will use simple get. And if I right click control dot, and then we can see it is giving a suggestion that it comes from Refit. And here we can define our method. It will be basically public, and it would be async method. So it, what it will return, it will give us summary response, and its name would be get summary. So that's all. So this is our interface. Okay, so why is it complaining? Okay, so basically it is asking us to give the path. So let me come here. So we are giving it just this path because this one will come from this URL. So let's paste somebody here. Okay, this one looks fine now. So what I have to do is just go there into my interface and paste same thing here. And then if I come here into my service, now it will ask us to implement this method. So let's use this option from VL Studio, and now we can implement this method. So now the question is how we are going to utilize our Refit client. So before going to add that Refit client here in our service, we have to do some sort of configuration in our program.cs file. So if I come here, I have to configure my Refit client here. So builder.services, and here we have a method named as Refit client, which basically we can see here, and we have to give it the name of our interface, basically our Refit interface. So I am giving it name. Perfect. And then we have to write it like configure HTTP client. And then we have to set the base address of our all requests. So here we will set base address, which would be basically a URL basically. So let me copy that from here. So let's paste it there. For this video, I am just hard coding it, but a better approach would be to keep it in the app setting and then reading it from there. So now this is all that we have to do. Now we can utilize this Refit API. We have to just go into our service, and we have to add our Refit interface. Let's use option of VL Studio to add okay. So it has automatically completed this. Let's see that it is giving us suggestion that we have one method called getSomebody, and we can save it into a variable. And then we can return it. We can do that in one line as well, but I prefer to keep it here so I can look at what it is retrieving. And it is a async call, so we have to put a wait and async with our method. That's all. Our service has been completed. Now let's go to our controller and implement. Now we have to inject our COVID service interface here, so we can call it. Okay, so this is how we add our COVID service. And now let's utilize again VL Studio, and it has done this for us. And now we can call that method get something, and we can return. I would prefer to make it async, and then I will define that what my response looks like. So in our current case, it is summary response. Okay, so this looks fine now. So that's all we have to do. Let's put a breakpoint here and run this API. It's taking time. Fine. So we have one method named as getSummary. So I have already created a postman request and I have added it here. So if we send the request send, okay, so it is complaining that URL path summary must start with, okay, cool, fair enough. And we have to go in there, and yes, we have to put the slash here. Let's rerun it. And let's call API again, and we have got there F10, then F11, F10, and here we can see that we have got the response. Let's continue it and look and see how it looks like in that school. So we have received the same response that we were retrieving here now using Refit client. Okay, so there is one more thing that I would like to share with you. Let me copy this code and let me stop it. If you don't like these naming conventions, and of course it is giving some sort of warnings as well, because either we have to make it nullable, then it will do. So let's copy this code. So now basically I have utilized this JSON property name attribute, and I have given proper attributes name. And what is the benefit of it is that now we can change the name according to my need, that how my names perfectly looks like, because I don't prefer to my names looks like latest underscore date. So I prefer this approach. So if you want to do something like that, then you can utilize JSON property name, but it will not change the response. Why is it complaining? Okay, so it is saying, okay, let's rerun it. It will take time building. Okay, so it's ready. Let's make our call again. Okay, let me remove that debugger. Perfect, it looks same as it was earlier. So this is the first approach or first way of calling the Refit client. In this approach we have basically utilized dependency injection way of calling Refit client, but there is another approach as well in which we are not utilizing basically this. So what it will do, let me now demonstrate second approach. Let me comment this out and go into my REST service, COVID service, sorry. And now what I have to do here, now I have to remove this one as well, nothing there. In second approach we basically use syntax like that. I think I have already copied it here somewhere to save some time. Yes, I have done it. So Yes. So here we are just using a REST service for, and then we are defining our interface, and then we are giving our base URL. So of course it's better way to put it in the app setting and then use it. And if we are using multiple, if we have multiple APIs, then better way would be to put it into a constructor and then use it. But for current scenario, we are just putting it in our method and calling our desired API. So in our case, we need this one, and let's return and then put await. So this is the second approach. Now let's call it and see how it looks like. But in this case, now we have to, we don't need to define complete URL because we have already then done it here. Let's call it again and see how it looks like now. Okay, so it is saying that no such host is now. My apology. Let's put the same base address that we used for previous request. And let's see now what it returns. Okay, it's fine. It's running. Go back to Postman. It's dev. Let's call on local, and when we call, it is returning the same response that it was giving us for other approach. So here are a few things that you should keep in mind, that if we are using it for multiple APIs, then put this implementation in constructor and then use it for all APIs, and always put this base address into app setting. I will hopefully make another video on that as well. So that's all that I wanted to demonstrate in this first video, that how we can set up Refit in .NET. So I hope you have enjoyed this video, and if you want to support me, you can subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.